So let's continue working in this main div area. I want to take this section and float it to the left of this section. So let's get some labels and see what we are working with. I'm going to want to take this subnav content with its H3 and its list, all of it. I want the subnav to float to the left of this main div, div ID equals main. And keeping in mind their parent tag is the content tab. So the content div holds both the subnav and the main. And those are the three things I'm going to be working with. I remember that when I float things, it takes them out of their HTML order. So it might bring this footer way up high. I don't know. It might. And it might also change this content. See this box that we have, the content in? That's 10% opaque. It might change that too because it's children who are the subnav and the main. Oops. Where's main? There it is down there. The main are going to be taken out of it by the mere fact of floating them takes them out. So we'll have to do something about that too. But let's begin right here by saying subnav, please float. Oops, I forgot the pound sign. Subnav, please float. And our instructions tell us that the width of that column should be 25%, whereas the width of this main column should be 75%, and it should be 400 pixels tall. So here we'll say width 25%. And now let's get the main. Oops, pound main. This too will float left. Remember, when you float two things, they'll go side by side. And this has a width of 75%. I did those just backwards, didn't I? There we go. Those are correct. Let's take a peek at it, and then we'll look a little further. So, yes, as I suspected, let me close this. My floats are working, but my footer doesn't realize now that the floats are anywhere on the page, so it's come way up. And the parent tag, which had an opacity on it, also doesn't recognize them. So to the footer, we need to say clear both. And to the content, we'll have to add that clear fix hack that I taught you a few weeks ago. And luckily, it's still in our, it's already in our styles. So let me get back over to Visual Studio. We will first tell the footer to clear both. Let's check to see how that looks. There, the footer is back in place. And now we have to add the clear fix hack to the content. So let's find the content. Yes. We need to do that on the HTML because that's a class. Let's just look at it so you can see it. I put the clear fix up here. So I'm going to go to the HTML. Ooh, where'd it go? There it is. And to the content, I will say class equals clearfix. Let's see how that worked. And there it is. Now I need to add the height here of this section, which was called main. And when I do add the height, I am going to want to set the overflow to auto, so that will give me a scroll bar. Because if I set the height to 400, it's just going to end here, and I won't see the rest of my content. So I'll set the overflow on that. Back to my styles. Back to the main. Where is it? Here it is. So I'll say height 400 pixels. And then I'll say overflow auto. And hopefully that will do what I'm expecting it to do. And here's my scroll bar working. I feel like I should do something about how the text shows up there. When I hover over the scroll bar, I see it white. But maybe inside my main, I should do, I don't know what. What would be the thing to do? Padding? Right, perhaps. Let's just see if that works. I'm worried that that will bring the scroll bar with it. I'll do a big amount so that it'll be easy to see. No, that worked. All right. And you'll see my scroll bar doesn't show up until I actually click and begin scrolling. There might be a new feature in Chrome that's making that happen. But now we need to play with the nav bar. Let's do that.